Are you looking for a rock solid ground mount that is easy to set up? Stick around, we're building one right now.
We're gonna build this thing backwards, so the high side's gonna be on this side so that we can get the forks back here without hitting the front of the panels. So what we're gonna do is measure the width of the panels over here, and then we're gonna measure out the width minus 1 inch, and that will be our spacing between these bottom rails, or tubes, I think they call them. So say that's, you know, 60 inches, we'll go 59 inches from here to here. We'll call it 44 and 5/8. So we'll go 43 and 5/8. And the racks go together real simple. They're pretty tight tolerance, so you gotta make sure you get them in there, but you've got a long arm, which is gonna go in the back, and you just put your bolt through it, and it's got a square socket on it right there, and so the bolt sucks into it just fine. And then we're gonna put another bolt in right here, and that would actually clamp down on this ground stake that we're not using.
This is a great time for me to mention that I'm partnering with Signature Solar to bring you a video on the IntegraRack BallastRack System. It is a super simple way to put a professional spin on a DIY ground mount. The basic racking system allows you to make pretty much whatever size array you want, and then you can use the earth ballast or the anchor spike mounting kits, or do what I did and just build your own. If you're interested, I'll leave a link in the description below, or you can scan this QR code right here. And also, don't forget to get your $50 off when you use my discount code, also in the description.
Put that second bolt through there, and then you've got the top, or the short leg, and it does the same thing. You clamp that down, and you see it just slides right on in. Slides in, bolt goes through, screws in. And no washer or lock washer, it's got the teeth on it. To secure them, since we're not using the built-in ground spikes, we went ahead and bought some Simpson strong tie timber hex screws. So these guys are gonna go down in here, they're gonna bite in pretty well. And then, because we've gotta go through here, I went ahead and bought half inch washers, but whatever, I don't know what the dimension is on that, big. Then we're also gonna put one on top and bottom. So put one here, and then one here. Necessary? No. Hopefully it'll eliminate water pooling under here and rock. All right, we got a half inch nut for 13. We're gonna take the 44 7/8 width of the panel, and then we're gonna subtract 1 inch off of that and go from here here. So we're going to be 43 7/8. So here's 42, 43 7/8. All right, now what I need to do is also go, that's 4 inches. So let's bring this to here. We're gonna double check 43 7/8. Yeah, I'm not quite there. We're actually gonna put one of these washers underneath too. So slide one under there. Okay. And 43 7/8, right there. 43 7/8 is right there, and the 4 inches is going to be spot on. Actually, we're wanting 5/8. Sorry, 5/8.
So 7/8.
I've been saying 7/8. 5/8.
dialing these wrong?
No, I've been putting these at 5/8 and saying 7/8. Yeah, that's 5/8. So measure out.
One component that doesn't come in the kit from Signature Solar is going to be this 1-inch EMT. You can get it at any big box store or your local hardware store. I got mine from Lowe's. The EMT slides through one of the two holes in the ballast rack system, and you basically get one stick for every two solar panels, at least in this configuration. So for my timber frame mount here, I ended up using two sticks. Now, as you can see here, I found out on the second half that if you just slide the EMT into each of the ballast racks, you'll end up being able to just slide them along. Once I get the end that I'm pushing right now into this center piece, everything else adjusts really easily. At this point, it's basically just putting in the rest of the screws, adjusting and tightening all the bolts, and then making sure that the EMT is fastened.
Soon we'll come back through here and tighten all those by hand. I don't have any torque specs on it, but just snug.
Installing this first panel was a little bit awkward. We didn't really know how to hold it or, you know, how to best position ourselves. We did put the two bottom clamps on or in place the best we knew how, and then we were able to just drop the bolts onto the top of those short poles. Those have a vertical slit that allows you to just slide it on top of it. Then we came back and installed the top side, and it was all just super awkward the first time, but we're gonna run back through this and I'll show you exactly how it goes together. The second time we repositioned to the two short ends of the solar panel, and this seemed to work out much better. So my oldest son here, he grabbed this front corner, I grabbed the other corner, and we just slid it into place. That was nice and easy. And then we slid the panel up a little bit and then came over and installed the backside. Once the clamps were in place, then we were able to just slide it up so that the two panels matched each other in height.
What happens whenever you connect this right here is these guys have little teeth that are biting in to the backside of this panel, creating continuity between the panels and the racking system all the way through the EMT. And so we can ground with a single point this unit, and the entirety of the panel will be grounded, or the entirety of the rack will be grounded.
And for the third panel, we finally started to get a groove.
So I find it easiest to go ahead and stick this on, take the nut off, screw the nut on, let it drop down, drop the nut, lose it somewhere. Stick that on. Put that on a little bit. Is pretty simple and it looks really good. So we had to stop working because, well, the sun went down, and then a cold front blew through and brought a whole bunch of rain, so this whole thing is gross, covered with pine needles and dirt from it hitting the ground. So unfortunately it's not nice and shiny and new anymore, but that's okay. Next thing I'm gonna do is connect positives to negatives. Actually, you know what, I'm gonna hold off on that. I'm gonna get it in place. So I'm gonna get the tractor, I'm gonna take it over to where it's gonna sit, and then we'll connect it. This thing is huge for what it is, just four panels, but it is sturdy. And it's a bit of an eyesore coming off the back of our house. Not that the back of our house looks any better, but all that's going to change. The goal is to get these panels up here on a large mount facing the south. But for now, this is what we've got. And I'm really happy with the way it turned out. So crawling under here. We're going to need to snip these, so I'll be back.
Here,
if you don't have a good pair of side snippers, yeah, you need to get some. It just makes cutting zip ties and all sorts of other things so much easier whenever you're dealing with solar panels. Now, if you were going to do optimizers, this would be a great time to do it. And the optimizers would actually go up here, and you would plug each of these into the optimizers, and then they'd go up here, and then the optimizers would then connect to each other. And I've got some examples of that in a video that's not yet released, but will be coming very soon on Mitch's Boss Build video series. And if you haven't seen that already, we took a 4,000 square foot home and we turned it into an off-grid setup using stuff that anybody can do. All right, well, let's get back into it. So I'm gonna take these, and right here, it shows this is negative. And I'm gonna, you know, honestly, I probably didn't even need to snip these. In fact, I don't even know that I'm gonna snip them for the rest now that I'm thinking about this. Pop off the cap, negative, and positive. Connect them just like that. So now we see we've got positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. Okay guys, so it's been a couple of days. Basically had to wait for the rain to stop, and now it's cold and windy and all that stuff. The base here is holding up great. It actually is starting to fade a little bit, which means I probably didn't get as good of a char on it as I would like. I also think I'm gonna go back and coat it with some oil, used motor oil and diesel. I think those two at a 50-50 ratio, or maybe just use motor oil. Problem is right now I don't have any, so I need to change the oil in my truck, but that's a different story. So I haven't plugged in, and you can actually see they are running down this way and running down that way. This is temporary, just for testing for right here. What I'm gonna end up doing is putting a disconnect right over here, but I don't have the glands or the box. Once I get that, I'll be able to turn it on and off right here, which is what you need to be code compliant. Also need to ground it, so I need to take a ground wire, go from here to my ground rod, and then that will keep anyone from walking up against this thing and feeling a little tingle. Also, if something catastrophic goes wrong, it'll keep that from hurting someone. This wind is nuts. We actually had a few tornadoes go through the area last night or yesterday evening. So even with all this wind, this hasn't budged. It's not gonna budge. This thing is so heavy. It's doing exactly what it was made to do. The ballast is super sturdy, and I couldn't be happier with this build. Let's go into the barn and check voltage. And you see right here, the sun is right up here. It's 10:44, and the sun is just coming up over the trees. Let's see what kind of voltage we're getting, and then let's plug it into a 6000 XP and see what we're getting on wattage. So here I have my positive and negatives running in from outside. This is a positive, this is a negative. Take my clamp meter and turn it over to volts, and we're gonna hit DC. We've got 143 volts DC between these two. The max PV voltage for these 6000 XPs, each one is 480 volts. So we are well within that range right there. I'm gonna go ahead and plug these guys in here. And this is the PV disconnect or isolator that I'm gonna put over on the array. Got this one right here. I need to drill out these holes, and then I need to put the watertight glands on it. Now this is connected, let's go ahead and flip it on. And let's check and see how many amps we're pulling. Looks like right now we're hitting about 9.5. So we should be doing about 1500 watts, right? So let's pull up the monitor app. So looking right here, we are at 1230 watts, 307 watts per panel. The sun is kind of heading back over here, and the panels are definitely not facing the sun at this point. So I think there's a lot more room to get more power out of these panels, and we're going to see that as the sun starts to move over here instead of over here.
That's it for now. Appreciate you making it to the end, and consider using my links and get your discount when you shop for anything solar related at signaturesolar.com. Also, if you didn't see the video where I built this timber frame base and ballast for the racking system, check out that video. Otherwise, check out what I did over at Mitch's place at his 4,000 square foot house. See you on the next one.